This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Governor of Texas Governorship 2000 Republican Primary President of the United States Policies Cabinet Domestic Economy Foreign Relations Bush Doctrine International Trips Judicial Appointments Legislation Bush v. Gore Florida Aftermath First Inauguration Presidency First Term September 11 War on Terrorism War in Afghanistan Invasion of Iraq Dismissal of U.S. Attorneys Controversy Email Controversy Second Term Campaign 2004 Second Inauguration War in Iraq Second Term State of the Union, 2006-2007 Iraq Surge Great Recession Stimulus Presidential Library Legacy Post-Presidency Decision Points Clinton Bush Haiti Fund 41, A Portrait of My Father V.E. The Presidency of George W. Bush began on January 20, 2001 at noon Eastern Standard Time, when he was inaugurated as the 43rd President of the United States, and ended on January 20, 2009 The oldest son of former President George H.W. Bush, he was elected President in 2000, and became the second U.S. president whose father had held the same office, succeeding John Quincy Adams after two recounts, then vice president and Democratic presidential candidate Al Gore filed a lawsuit for a third the Supreme Court's highly controversial decision in Bush v. Gore resolved the dispute the Florida Secretary of State certified Bush as the winner of Florida the state's 25 electoral votes gave Bush 271 electoral votes, enough to defeat Gore Bush was re-elected in 2004 defeating Democratic candidate and United States Senator from Massachusetts John Kerry as president. Bush pushed through a $13 trillion tax cut program and the No Child Left Behind Act, and also pushed for socially conservative efforts, such as the Partial Birth Abortion Ban Act and faith-based welfare initiatives. Nearly 8 million people immigrated to the United States in 2000-2005, nearly half entered illegally during his two terms. The United States lost over 6 million manufacturing jobs, about one-third of the total at the end of the Clinton administration after the terrorist attacks on September 11, 2001. Bush declared a global war on terrorism and, in October 2001, ordered an invasion of Afghanistan to overthrow the Taliban, destroy al-Qaeda, and to capture Osama bin Laden in March 2003, Bush received a mandate from the U.S. Congress to lead an invasion of Iraq, asserting that Iraq was in violation of UN Security Council Resolution 1441. Bush also initiated an AIDS program that committed $15 billion to combat AIDS over 5 years. His record as a humanitarian included helping enroll as many as 29 million of Africa's poorest children in schools. On his second full day in office, Bush reinstated the Mexico City policy. This policy required any non-governmental organization receiving U.S. government funding to refrain from performing or promoting abortion services in other countries running as a self-styled war president in the midst of the Iraq War. Bush won re-election in 2004, as his campaign against Senator John Kerry was successful despite controversy over Bush's prosecution of the Iraq War and his handling of the economy. His second term was highlighted by several free trade agreements, the Energy Policy Act of 2005 alongside a strong push for offshore and domestic drilling, the nominations of Supreme Court Justices John G. Roberts and Samuel Alito, a push for Social Security and immigration reform, his administration's response to Hurricane Katrina, a surge of troops in Iraq, which was followed by a drop in violence, and several different economic initiatives aimed at preventing a banking system collapse, stopping foreclosures, and stimulating the economy during the recession. The approval ratings of George W. Bush have, at different points in time, run the gamut from high to all-time record low. Bush began his presidency with ratings near 50% in the time of national crisis following the September 11 attacks. Polls showed approval ratings of greater than 85%, peaking in one October 2001 poll at 92%, and a steady 80-90% approval for about 4 months after the attacks. Afterward, his ratings steadily declined as the economy suffered and the Iraq War initiated by his administration continued. By early 2006, his average rating was averaging below 40%, and in July 2008, a poll indicated a near all-time low of 22%. Upon leaving office, the final poll recorded his approval rating as 19%, a record low for any U.S. president. Contents 1 Major Issues of Presidency 11 Major Acts as President 111 Foreign Policy Actions 112 Economic Policy Actions 113 13 Domestic Policy Actions 12 State of the Union Addresses 2 International Treaties Signed 21 Major Treaties President Bush withdrew from 3 major legislation 31 legislation signed 311, 2001, 312, 2002, 313, 2003. 314-2004, 315-2005, 316-2006, 317-2007, 318-2008, 32 Legislation vetoed 4 Administration and Cabinet 41 Cabinet Members 411 Attorney General 412 Labor 413 Energy 414 Homeland Security 42 Advisors and Other Officials 43 Military Nominations and Appointments 44 Supreme Court Nominations and Appointments 45 Court of Appeals Nominations and Appointments 46 Federal Reserve Appointment 5 International Trips 6 First Term 2001-2005 7 Second Term 2005-2009 8 Political Philosophy 9 Environmental Record 10 Legacy 11 See also 12 References 13 External links Major issues of presidency Major acts as president Foreign policy actions responding to the September 11, 2001 attacks declaring the war on terrorism waging the Afghanistan war against Osama bin Laden, al-Qaeda, and the Taliban government waging the 2003 invasion of Iraq and the Iraq War against Saddam Hussein and the Arab Socialist Ba'ath Party Government U.S.-Iraq Status of Forces Agreement. Establishing prison for terror suspects at Guantanamo Bay USA Patriot Act Establishing the United States Department of Homeland Security Establishing the Office of the Director of National Intelligence President's Emergency Plan for AIDS Relief Dominican Republic Central America Free Trade Agreement Economic Policy Actions The Bush Tax Cuts Economic Growth and Tax Relief Reconciliation Act of 2001 Job Creation and Worker Assistance Act of 2002 Jobs and Growth Tax Relief Reconciliation Act of 2003 Responding to the Late 2000s Recession Economic Stimulus Act of 2008 Public Law 110-343 DIVA, Emergency Economic Stabilization Act of 2008 DIVB, Energy Improvement and Extension Act of 2008 DIVC, Tax Extenders and Alternative Minimum Tax Relief Act of 2008 Sarbanes-Oxley Act Domestic Policy Actions Education No Child Left Behind Act Social Policy Partial Birth Abortion Ban Act Establishing the White House Office of Faith-Based and Community Initiatives Other Responding to Hurricane Katrina Creation of Medicare Part D State of the Union Addresses Main Article, President Bush's Speeches First Inaugural Address January 20, 2001 Second Inaugural Address January 20, 2005 2001 Address Not Officially a State of the Union Address February 27, 2001-2002 State of the Union Address January 29, 2002-2003 State of the Union Address January 28, 2003-2004 State of the Union Address January 20, 2004-2005 State of the Union Address February 2, 2005-2006 State of the Union Address January 31, 2006-2007 State of the Union Address January 23, 2007-2008 State of the Union Address January 28, 2008 International Treaties Signed George W. Bush signed several international treaties, including but not limited to, SORT 2002 better known as the Moscow Treaty, the United States and Russia agreed to limit their nuclear arsenal to 1,700-2,200 operationally deployed warheads each Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants 2001 International Cooperation on Computer Crimes 2001 Involvement of Children in Armed Conflict 2000 Sale of Children, Child Prostitution and Pornography 2000 Major Treaties President Bush withdrew from ABM Treaty 2002 Limited Anti-Ballistic Missile ABM systems used in defending areas against missile-delivered nuclear weapons between the United States and the USSR United Nations Population Fund 2002 promoted the human right of reproductive health, that is physical, mental, and social health in matters related to reproduction and the reproductive system major legislation. Legislation signed 2001 May 26, the 2001 Bush Tax Cuts Through Reconciliation Procedure June 7, Economic Growth and Tax Relief Reconciliation Act of 2001 September 18, Authorization for Use of Military Force Against Terrorists September 28, United States-Jordan Free Trade Area Implementation Act October 26, USA Patriot Act November 28, Internet Tax Nondiscrimination Act 2002 January 8, No Child Left Behind behind Act March 9, Job Creation and Worker Assistance Act of 2002 March 27, Bipartisan Campaign Reform Act of 2002 May 13, Farm Security and Rural Investment Act of 2002 July 30, Sarbanes-Oxley Act of 2002 October 16, Joint Resolution to Authorize the Use of United States Armed Forces Against Iraq October 29, Help America Vote Act November 25, Homeland Security Act of 2002. 2003 March 11, Do Not Call Implementation Act April 30, Protect Act of 2003 Prosecutorial Remedies and Other Tools to End the Exploitation of Children Today Act See also Age of Consent May 23. 2004 April 1, Unborn Victims of Violence Act Lacey and Connors Law July 17, United States-Morocco Free Trade Agreement Implementation Act August 3, United States-Australia Free Trade Agreement Implementation Act October 18, Homeland Security Appropriations Act of 2004 December 17, Intelligence Reform and Terrorism Prevention Act of 2004-2005 February 18, Class Action Fairness Act of 2005 April 20, Bankruptcy Reform Act of 2005 May 11, Tax Increase Prevention and Reconciliation Act of 2005 through Reconciliation Procedure August 2, Dominican Republic Central America United States Free Trade Agreement Implementation Act August 8, Energy Policy Act of 2005 August 10, Safe, Accountable, Flexible, and Efficient Transportation Equity Act of 2005 Safety October 26, Protection of Lawful Commerce in Arms Act December 21. Procedure 2006 January 11, United States-Bahrain Free Trade Agreement Implementation Act March 9, USA Patriot Improvement and Reauthorization Act July 27, Adam Walsh Child Protection and Safety Act August 17, the Pension Protection Act of 2006 September 30, Iran Freedom and Support Act October 4, Department of Homeland Security Appropriations Act 2007 October 17, Military Commissions Act of 2006 October 26, Secure Fence Act of 2006-2007 May 25, U.S. Troop Readiness, Veterans Care, Katrina Recovery, and Iraq Accountability Appropriations Act, 2007 December 19, Energy Independence and Security Act of 2007 August 5, Protect America Act of 2007 PAA, PUBL 110-55, 121. January 28, National Defense Authorization Act for Fiscal Year 2008 February 13, Economic Stimulus Act of 2008 October 3, Public Law 110-343 DIVA, Emergency Economic Stabilization Act of 2008 DIVB, Energy Improvement and Extension Act of 2008 DIVC, Tax Extenders and Alternative Minimum Tax Relief Act of 2008 Legislation vetoed Republican seats in Congress Congress Senate House 107th 50,221,108 51,229,109 55,232,110 49,202 President Bush vetoed 12 pieces of legislation, four of which were overturned by Congress. July 19, 2006, Stem Cell Research Enactment Act of 2006 May 1, 2007, H.R. 1591, U.S. Troop Readiness, Veterans Care, Katrina Recovery, and Iraq Accountability Appropriations Act of 2007 June 20, 2007, Stem Cell Research Enactment Act of 2007 October 3, 2007, State Children's Health Insurance Program Expansion H.R. 976 November 2, 2007, vetoed H.R. 1495, Water Resources Development Act of 2007 overridden by House, 361-54-277 votes needed overridden by Senate, 79-14-62 needed, and enacted as PUBL 110-114 over President's veto November 13, 2007, vetoed H.R. 3043, Departments of Labor, Health and Human Services, and Education, and Related Agencies Appropriations Act of 2008 Override Attempt failed in House, 277-141-279 votes needed. December 12, 2007, vetoed H.R. 3963, Children's Health Insurance Program Reauthorization Act of 2007 Override attempt failed in House, 260-152 275 votes needed December 28, 2007, pocket vetoed H.R. 1585, National Defense Authorization Act for Fiscal Year 2008 A later version of the bill that changed a minor provision of which the President disapproved was quickly passed by Congress H.R. 4986 and was enacted with the President's approval as PUBL 110-181 on January 28, 2008 March 8, 2008, vetoed H.R. 2082, Intelligence Authorization Act for Fiscal Year 2008 Override attempt failed in House, 225-188 May 21, 2008, vetoed H.R. 2419, 2007 U.S. Farm, Bill overridden by House, 316-108 283 votes needed overridden by Senate, 8-2-13-64 votes needed enacted as PUBL 110-234 over the President's veto due to a clerical error. This act was repealed by PUBL 110-246 June 18, 2008, vetoed H.R. 6421, 2007 U.S. Farm Bill, repassed by Congress to correct a clerical error in H.R. 2419 overridden by House, 317-109 284 votes required overridden by Senate, 80-14-63 votes needed enacted as PUBL 110-246 over the President's veto July 15, 2008, vetoed H.R. 6331, Medicare Improvements for Patients and Providers Act overridden by House, 383-41-283 votes required overridden by Senate, 70-26-64 votes required enacted as PUBL 110-275 over the President's veto administration and cabinet. Cabinet meeting Bush's cabinet had included figures that were prominent in past administrations. This is notably former Secretary of State Colin Powell, who had served as United States National Security Advisor under Ronald Reagan. Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld had served as White House Chief of Staff and Secretary of Defense under Gerald Ford. Rumsfeld's successor, Robert Gates, served as Director of Central Intelligence under George H.W. Bush. Vice President Dick Cheney served as Secretary of Defense under George H.W. Bush. Bush placed a high value on personal loyalty and, as a result, his administration had high message discipline. He maintained a hands-off style of management. I'm confident in my management style. I'm a delegator because I trust the people I've asked to join the team. I'm willing to delegate. That makes it easier to be president, he said in an interview with Diane Sawyer on ABC in December 2003. Critics alleged, however, that Bush was willing to overlook mistakes made by loyal subordinates. The Bush cabinet office name term President. George W. Bush 2001-2009 Vice President Dick Cheney 2001-2009 Secretary of State Colin Powell 2001-2005 Condoleezza Rice 2005-2009 Secretary of Treasury Paul O'Neill 2001-2002 John W. Snow 2003-2006 Henry Paulson 2006-2009 Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld 2001-2006 Robert Gates 2006-2009 Attorney General John Ashcroft 2001-2005 Alberto Gonzalez 2005-2007 Michael Mukasey 2007-2009 Secretary of the Interior Gail Norton 2001-2006 Dirk Kempthorne 2006-2009 Secretary of Agriculture Ann Veneman 2001-2005 Mike Johanns 2005-2007 Ed Schaefer 2008-2009 Secretary of Commerce Donald Evans 2001-2005 Carlos Gutierrez 2005-2009 Secretary of Labor Elaine Chao 2001-2009 Secretary of Health and Human Services Tommy Thompson 2001-2005 Mike Levitt 2005-2009 Secretary of Education Rod Page 2001-2005 Margaret Spellings 2005-2009 Secretary of Housing and Urban Development Mel Martinez 2001-2003 Alfonso Jackson 2003-2008 Steve Preston 2008-2009 Secretary of Transportation Norman Mineta 2001-2006 Mary Peters 2006-2009 Secretary of Energy Spencer Abraham 2001-2005 Samuel Bodman 2005-2009 Secretary of Veterans Affairs Anthony Principe 2001-2005 Jim Nicholson 2005-2007 James Peake 2007-2009 Secretary of Homeland Security Tom Ridge 2003-2005 Michael Chertoff 2005-2009 Chief of Staff Andrew Card 2001-2006 Joshua Bolton 2006-2009 Administrator of the Environmental Protection Agency Christine Todd Whitman 2001-2003 Mike Levitt 2003-2005 Stephen L. Johnson 2005-2009 Director of the Office of Management and Budget Mitch Daniels 2001-2003 Joshua Bolton 2003-2006 Rob Portman 2006-2007 Jim Nussel 2007-2009 Director of the Office of National Drug Control Policy John P. Walters 2001-2009 United States Trade Representative Robert Zolik 2001-2005 Rob Portman 2005-2006 Susan Schwab 2006-2009 There was only one non-Republican in Bush's cabinet, Secretary of Transportation Norman Mineta. The first Asian American cabinet secretary, who had previously served as Secretary of Commerce under Bill Clinton, is a Democrat. Mineta resigned from Bush's cabinet on July 7, 2006 to pursue other challenges. Mary Peters, a Republican, was nominated and confirmed to succeed him as Transportation Secretary. At least one other non-Republican was apparently offered a position in the administration but declined. CNN reported that in the transition to his second term, Bush offered the positions of Ambassador to the United Nations and subsequently Secretary of Homeland Security to Senator Joe Lieberman. Then a Democrat and currently an independent Democrat in 2006, Bush replaced longtime Chief of Staff Andrew Card with Joshua Bolton and made major staff and cabinet changes with the intention of revitalizing his administration on November 8, 2006. The day after the Democrats took back Congress in the midterm elections, Bush announced plans to replace Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld with former CIA Director Robert Gates. Gates was confirmed by the United States Senate on December 6 and took office as the 22nd Secretary of Defense on December 18. Cabinet members Attorney General Bush's first Attorney General, John Ashcroft, was politically controversial, and viewed by many as incompetent according to the sworn testimony of two FBI agents interviewed by the 9/11 Commission. Ashcroft ignored warnings of an imminent al-Qaeda attack. Ashcroft resigned. Days after Bush's 2004 re-election, Bush's second attorney general was Alberto Gonzalez. In addition to his work on providing guidelines for detainee interrogation methods prior to his appointment, he claimed there was no right to habeas corpus for detained combatants. Michael Mukasey succeeded Gonzalez and was the country's 81st attorney general. Main article, Dismissal of U.S. Attorneys Controversy. Main article, NSA Warrantless Surveillance Controversy. Labor. Bush's first nomination for Secretary of Labor was Linda Chavez. This nomination came under attack when evidence came to light that she had given money to an illegal immigrant from Guatemala who lived in her home. Chavez claimed that the woman was not an employee and she had merely provided her with emergency assistance due to the domestic abuse the woman had been facing at the time. Chavez's nomination was withdrawn instead. Bush nominated Elaine Chao, a former official with the administrations with Ronald Reagan and George H.W. Bush, who was confirmed by the Senate. Chao was the only member of Bush's cabinet to serve during Bush's entire tenure as President. Energy. Bush's first Secretary of Energy, Spencer Abraham, was controversial at the time of his 2001 appointment because as a senator he co-sponsored S-896, a bill to abolish the United States Department of Energy. In 1999, Samuel Wright Bodman III, SCD, replaced Abraham as United States Secretary of Energy in 2005 and remained in this position until January 2009. Bodman was previously Deputy Secretary of the Department of the Treasury Homeland Security when Tom Ridge announced his decision to resign as Secretary of Homeland Security. Bush's first choice to replace him was Bernard Carrick, who served as Police Commissioner of the City of New York during the September 11, 2009 2001 attacks, Carrick's nomination raised controversy when it was discovered that he had previously hired an undocumented worker as a nanny and housekeeper. After a week, Carrick pulled his nomination and Bush went on to nominate Michael Chertoff, advisors and other officials, Deputy Secretary of Defense, Paul Wolfowitz 2001-2005, Gordon R. England 2005-2009 CIA Director, George Tenet 2001-2004, John E. McLaughlin Acting, 2004, Porter J. Goss 2004-2006, Michael Hayden 2006-2009 FBI Director, Louis Free 2001, Thomas J. Picard Acting, 2001, Robert S. Mueller 2001-2009 NASA Administrator, Sean O'Keefe 2001-2005, Michael D. Griffin 2005-2009 FAA Administrator, Marion Blakey 2002-2007, Robert A. Sturgill Acting 2007-2009 FDA Commissioner, Mark McClellan 2002-2004, Lester Crawford 2005, Andrew von Eschenbach 2005-2009 National Security Advisor, Condoleezza Rice 2001-2005, Stephen Hadley 2005-2009 Deputy National Security Advisor for Iraq and Afghanistan, Megan O'Sullivan 2007, Douglas Lute 2007-2009 Ambassador to the United Nations, John Negroponte 2001-2004, John Danforth 2004, John R. Bolton 2005-2006, Zalmay Khalilzad 2007-2009 FCC Chairman, Michael Powell 2001-2005, Kevin Martin 2005-2009 White House Deputy Chief of Staff, Joe Hagen 2001-2008, Joshua Bolton 2001-2003, Harriet Mears 2003-2004, Karl Rove 2005-2007, Joel Kaplan 2006-2009, Blake Gottsman 2008-2009 Director of National Intelligence, John Negroponte 2005-2007, John Michael McConnell 2007-2009 White House Counsel, Alberto R. Gonzalez 2001-2005, Harriet Mears 2005-2007, Fred Fielding 2007-2009 White House Press Secretary, Ari Fleischer 2001-2003, Scott McClellan 2003-2006, Tony Snow 2006-2007, Dana Perino 2007-2009 Senior Advisor to the President, Karl Rove 2001-2007, Barry Stephen Jackson 2007-2009 Chief of Staff to the Vice President of the United States, Louis Libby 2001-2005, David Addington 2005-2009 Counselor to the President, Karen Hughes 2001-2002, Dan Bartlett 2002-2007, Ed Gillespie 2007-2009 Military Nominations and Appointments Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Richard B. Myers 2001-2005, Peter Pace 2005-2007, Michael Mullen 2007-2011 Chief of Staff of the United States Army, Peter Shoemaker 2003-2007, George W. Casey Jr. 2007-2011 Chief of Staff of the United States Air Force, John P. Jumper 2001-2005, T. Michael Mosley 2005-2008, Norton A. Schwartz 2008-2012 Chief of Naval Operations, Michael Mullen 2005-2007, Gary Rawhead 2007-2011 Commandant of the Marine Corps, Michael Hagee 2003-2006, James T. Conway 2006-2010 Supreme Court Nominations and Appointments Main Article, George W. Bush Supreme Court Candidates Bush nominated the following people to the Supreme Court of the United States, John G. Roberts 2005, was first nominated for Associate Justice replacing Sandra Day O'Connor, after the death of Chief Justice William Rehnquist, Bush nominated him for the position of Chief Justice confirmed, 78-22 Harriet Mears 2005, was nominated upon the elevation of John G. Roberts as the Chief Justice her nomination was later withdrawn Samuel Alito 2006, nominated in 2005 upon the withdrawal of Harriet Mears confirmed, 58-42 Court of Appeals Nominations and Appointments Main Article, George W. Bush Judicial Appointment Controversies Jeffrey R. Howard First Circuit 2002 Barrington Daniels Parker Jr. Second Circuit 2001 Rena Raggi Second Circuit 2002 Richard C. Wesley Second Circuit 2003 Peter W. Hall Second Circuit 2004 Deborah Ann Van Livingston Second Circuit 2007. D. Brooks Smith Third Circuit 2002. Michael Chertoff Third Circuit 2003. D. Michael Fisher Third Circuit 2003. Franklin Stewart Van Antwerpen Third Circuit 2004. Michael A. Chaggers Third Circuit 2006. Kentucky A. Jordan Third Circuit 2006. Thomas M. Hardiman Third Circuit 2007. Roger L. Gregory Fourth Circuit 2001. Dennis W. Shedd Fourth Circuit 2002. Allison K. Duncan Fourth Circuit 2003. G. Stephen Agee Fourth Circuit 2008. Edith Brown Clement Fifth Circuit 2001. Edward C. Prado Fifth Circuit 2003. Priscilla Owen Fifth Circuit 2005. Jennifer Walker Ilrod Fifth Circuit 2007. Leslie H. Southwick Fifth Circuit 2007. Katharina Haynes Fifth Circuit 2008. Julia Smith Gibbons Sixth Circuit 2002. John M. Rogers Sixth Circuit 2002. Jeffrey S. Sutton Sixth Circuit 2003. Deborah L. Cook Sixth Circuit 2003. David W. McKeague Sixth Circuit 2005. Richard Allen Griffin Sixth Circuit 2005. Susan Beek Nielsen Sixth Circuit 2005. Raymond M. Kethledge Sixth Circuit 2008. Helena N. White Sixth Circuit 2008. Diane S. Sykes Seventh Circuit 2004. John Daniel Tinder Seventh Circuit 2007. William J. Riley Eighth Circuit 2001. Michael Joseph Melloy Eighth Circuit 2002. Levensky R. Smith Eighth Circuit 2002. Stephen M. Coloton Eighth Circuit 2003. Raymond W. Gruender Eighth Circuit 2004. William Dwayne Benton Eighth Circuit 2004. Bobby E. Shepard Eighth Circuit 2006. Richard R. Clifton Ninth Circuit 2002. J. Bybee Ninth Circuit 2003. Consuelo Maria Callahan Ninth Circuit 2003. Carlos T. B. Ninth Circuit 2003. Milan D. Smith Jr. Ninth Circuit 2006. Sandra Siegel Ikuta Ninth Circuit 2006. N. Randy Smith Ninth Circuit 2007. Harris L. Hartz Tenth Circuit 2001. Terrence L. O'Brien Tenth Circuit 2002. Michael W. McConnell Tenth Circuit 2002. Timothy M. Timkovich Tenth Circuit 2003. Neil M. Gorsuch Tenth Circuit 2006. Jerome A. Holmes Tenth Circuit 2006. William H. Pryor Jr. 11th Circuit 2004. John Roberts, D.C. Circuit 2003. Janice Rogers Brown, D.C. Circuit 2005. Thomas B. Griffith, D.C. Circuit 2005. Brett M. Kavanaugh, D.C. Circuit 2006. Sharon Prost, Federal Circuit 2001. Kimberly Ann Moore, Federal Circuit 2006. Federal Reserve appointment on October 24, 2005. Bush nominated Ben Bernanke to succeed Alan Greenspan as chairman of the Federal Reserve. The Senate Banking Committee recommended Bernanke's confirmation by a 13-to-1 voice vote on November 16, 2005, with the full Senate's approval on January 31, 2006. By another voice vote, Bernanke was sworn in on February 1, 2006. International trips. Main article: List of international presidential trips made by George W. Bush. Countries visited by President George W. Bush, 2001-2009. Bank. During his presidency, he visited six continents: Africa, Asia, Australia, Europe, North America, and South America. On one of his two trips to sub-Saharan Africa, he visited three of the poorest countries in the world: Liberia, Rwanda, and Benin. He was the first sitting president to visit Albania, Bahrain, Benin, Estonia, Georgia, Lithuania, Mongolia, Qatar, Slovakia, Sweden, and the United Arab Emirates. Bush also made a secret trip to Iraq on Thanksgiving Day 2003 to dine with the troops. His father had made a similar visit to the U.S. troops in Saudi Arabia in 1990. On November 15-20, 2006, Bush made the third round the world presidential flight after Johnson and Nixon. The number of visits per country where he traveled are: one visit to Albania, Argentina, Austria, Bahrain, Benin, Botswana, Bulgaria, Chile, Croatia, Denmark, El Salvador, Estonia, Georgia, Ghana, Guatemala, Hungary, India, Kosovo, Kuwait, Liberia, Lithuania, Mongolia, Netherlands, Nigeria, Pakistan, Panama, Philippines, Portugal, Qatar, Rwanda, Senegal, Slovakia, South Africa, Spain, Sweden, Tanzania, Turkey, Uganda, Ukraine, United Arab Emirates, Uruguay, Vietnam, and the West Bank. Two visits to Afghanistan, Australia, Belgium, Brazil, Colombia, Czech Republic, Indonesia, Ireland, Israel, Jordan, Latvia, Peru, Romania, Saudi Arabia, Singapore, Slovenia, and Thailand. 3 visits to Egypt, South Korea, and Poland, 4 visits to Canada, China, France, Iraq, and Japan, 5 visits to Germany, the United Kingdom, and Vatican City, 6 visits to Italy and Mexico, 7 visits to Russia. First term 2001-2005. Main article: George W. Bush's first term as President of the United States. Second term 2005-2009. Main article: George W. Bush's second term as President of the United States. Political philosophy: the guiding political philosophy of the Bush administration has been termed neoconservative. The specific elements of neoconservative leadership have been itemized in policy papers by leading members of the Project for a New American Century, and is represented in the editorial perspective of the political journal The Weekly Standard. Administration officials chosen from the membership of the Project for a New American Century PNAC began with the selection of the candidate for Vice President, Dick Cheney. Others included Richard Armitage, Zalmay Khalilzad, Lewis Scooter Libby, Richard Perle, former U.S. Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld, and Paul Wolfowitz. In 1998, members of the PNAC, including Rumsfeld and Wolfowitz, wrote to President Bill Clinton urging him to remove Saddam Hussein from power using U.S. diplomatic, political, and military power. In September 2000, the PNAC issued a report entitled Rebuilding America's Defenses, Strategies, Forces, and Resources for a New Century, proceeding from the belief that America should seek to preserve and extend its position of global leadership by maintaining the preeminence of U.S. military forces. The group stated that when diplomacy or sanctions fail, the United States must be prepared to take military action. The PNAC argued that the Cold War deployment of forces was obsolete. Defense spending and force deployment must reflect the post-Cold War duties that U.S. forces are obligated to perform. Constabulary duties such as peacekeeping in the Balkans and the enforcement of the no-fly zones in Iraq put a strain upon, and reduced the readiness of, U.S. forces. The PNAC recommended the forward redeployment of U.S. forces at new strategically placed permanent military bases in Southeast Europe and Southeast Asia. Permanent bases would ease the strain on U.S. forces, allowing readiness to be maintained and the carrier fleet to be reduced. Furthermore, PNAC advocated that the U.S. globalized military should be enlarged, equipped, and restructured for the constabulary roles associated with shaping the security in critical regions of the world environmental record.